Thank you. and it's about acceptance. They taking the final words and making sense and looking up to heaven, you set the blessing on the thing, let them, and gave them to his disciples to set before the Father. They all went and were satisfied. Jesus is the Father for Christ. And as we heard, it takes place in what is described as a deserted place. It is clear that the prophet that followed Jesus into the countryside. Now, it's really important to note that in the previous chapter to what we heard this evening, Jesus had raised Jairus' daughter from the dead. And so Jesus had shown himself to be mighty in word and in deed. This was enough to inspire some to follow him unprepared into this moment of grace. Maybe others came in search of something more. To hear what God's kingdom is, why not from feeling that new life, or to experience maybe that even in our lives when the events have gone so well. One of those gospel moments when it is hard to know if it was only the vocation that was lonely or the heart that so many young people discovered. So, they were willing to follow him. They were willing to risk and the hunger, and even the long walk home, just to be with this mighty prophet. And it is true that Jesus meets them at the deepest need. Not only their physical need for food, but their need for his compassionate care. So as we celebrate the solemnity of Corpus Christi, or the most holy and blood of Christ, we are, in many ways, like the pride in the gospel today. We too have gathered in the strength that we have come with our hopes and our needs to have come to Jesus. And we feel Jesus creates a Eucharistic world where we can experience his real presence and the hope of something better. So here too, no one may have those hungry. Jesus meets our needs by giving desire to be something with Christ in the offerings with real purpose. Thank you. resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we are in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. With me today upon the operation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, and then we will another by the body and the blood of the Son, and filled with the Holy Spirit, that become one body, one spirit in Christ. Let you make us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your kingdom, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles, and with all of the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for until they come. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation be planned and made, that God's sufficient salvation of all the world be pleased and firm in faith and charity our pilgrims of Christ, with your servant Francis our Pope, further than justified bishops, rulers, and all the clergy, and the entire people that you have gained from all your reign. Listen graciously to the words of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Join Christ, brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you with their message from this life, give kind weapons to work in you. May we hope to enjoy forever the promise of your glory, and praise the Lord, and will you bestow on the world, and that is good. That by the help of my blessing, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, by peace I leave you, and peace I give you, look not to our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who did it reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us greet one another with the peace of Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
but wait, all eternity